So let's jump to slide 33 and then 34. So I'm going to dive into the four performance categories and what you need to know. So on slide 34, the first performance category that I'll talk about is quality. Quality counts for 60% of your final score. Your final score will be a number that ranges from either 0 to 100. And you want to ensure that your final score is above the number 3. If your final score is above the number 3, that means that you will not be getting a penalty and that you would be getting a slight or potentially higher bonus, depending upon where you rank between that 3 to 100 scale. So what makes up your final score, the first category, again, is quality. We have finalized over 270, 80 measures that are available. The requirements are that you would need to select 6 measures. One of those would need to be an outcome measure. If an outcome measure isn't available, you would need to select another high priority measure, such as appropriate use, patient experience, patient safety, efficiency, or care coordination. And again, you can make the selection either through our comprehensive set of close to 300 measures, or you could make this selection from a specialty set. So let's move on to slide 35. So what does this mean, again, within the context of the Pick Your Pace? So under Pick Your Pace, test for quality would be submitting one quality measure, and partial and full could mean submitting 6 quality measures with one outcome or one high priority. In all instances, it doesn't mean that you have to do 6 quality measures. If you find that you are able to do 3 or 4 measures, we would encourage you to do that. Let's move on to slide 36, the cost performance category. So we haven't talked too much about cost, and the reason why we haven't is because we're actually not assessing cost for payment purposes in this first year. Rather, we will be calculating the cost performance category based off of your claims data that you submit to us. And we will provide you feedback on how you performed on the cost category. We have included 2 measures that were previously part of the physician value modifier, the Medicare spending per beneficiary, and a total cost measure. And we also have included 10 episode measures. So let's move on to slide 37, the improvement activities performance category. So this is the new category that's available under MIPS. This was not previously available under the PQRS or VM or meaningful use program. It's brand new. And so what improvement activities does is it really deals with practice improvements that you make within your own practice. We have over 90 activities to select from that span 9 categories. Those categories are listed on the slide here. And generally, for most clinicians, to get the fullest points under improvement activities, so there's 15 points here, they would have to do no more than 4 activities. On slide 38, there are a couple special considerations under this category for certain types of clinicians. So the first is if you are part of a small practice, you're a solo practitioner, if you work in a rural or HPSA area, the most you would have to do to get the fullest points here is 2 activities. Also, if you are part of a patient-centered medical home, you automatically get full credit under this category. And then there are also some special considerations if you are part of an APM where you can get full points. So let's move on to slide 39. So what does improvement activities mean for the Pick Your Pace? So again, test means attesting to one improvement activity for 90 days. Partial and full means attesting to either the maximum of 4 activities, or depending upon the activities you select, you may have to do a little bit less. we do have a high weighting and a medium weighting of these activities. So you could do 2 high-weighted activities or 4 medium activities or any combination to get you there. So let's move on to slide 40, the last performance category, which is advancing care information. Again, this deals with the usage of electronic health records, and this counts for 25 points towards your final score. What we've done with the advancing care information performance category is we've really restructured this from the way it previously worked under meaningful use. We heard a lot of feedback that the way it was working wasn't working, that we didn't have enough flexibility in there, and that if you missed one measure, you would potentially fail completely. So we've reworked it to build in a base score and a performance score, where there are 2 sets of measures to choose from based off of your addition of EHR. So on slide 41, you can see what those measure sets are. If you have either 25 edition certified EHR technology, a 2015 edition rather, or if you have the 2014 edition. And then on slide 42, so what does this mean under the pick your pace? So the test would mean that you would do the base measures. Again, those are either 4 or 5 measures, depending upon your addition of certified EHR technology. And then partial or full would mean doing more than the base, so doing some of the elements that are part of the performance side of advancing care information. On slide 43, there are some additional flexibilities under this category. We will automatically reweight this category, and what I mean by reweighting is that we will zero it out and give those 25 points to the quality category. So that means your quality portion of your final score would now count for 85 points. So that happens if you are a hospital-based clinician, if you are a non-patient-facing clinician, or if you are a nurse practitioner, physician assistant, certified registered nurse anesthetist, or clinical nurse specialist. You do not have to participate in the advancing care information category. You can, however, choose to do so, and if you do, then we will assess you based off of the information you provide to us. You also, if you don't meet any of these under number 1, you can also ask for us to reweight this category to quality for 3 reasons. 1, if you have insufficient internet activity, if there are extreme and uncontrollable circumstances, and then the 3rd is if you have lack of control over your ability of certified EHR technology. For those of you who are familiar with the Meaningful Use Program, these are very similar to the hardship exceptions that were previously available there.